episode of Marvin Says. And for today's episode, this is again to document the repair done to the 2012 Subaru Legacy GT. And without further ado, umpisa na natin. Okay, so last Saturday, no, I went to Manila for the Subaru Legacy repair, in which ang pinagawa doon was the power steering pump. And may isa pang nakita yung mekaniko, lower arm bushings. So yun yung pinalitan, okay, yung bushing. Alright, so bakit nagkaroon ng leak sa power steering pump? As you all know, the Subaru Legacy 2012, I purchased it last June of 2021, that was last year. And ang nakapansin ng tagas, yung pinsan ko, no, after coming from the CASA motor image dito sa may Dagupan, Pangasinan, no, I went to have it checked by my cousin, and napansin niya bakit may basa doon sa engine bay. So we found out na may tagas doon sa power steering pump. Okay, so hindi ko siya pinansin kasi drivable naman, no. And nung Sabado or prior to Saturday, I was actually booking for an appointment with the first option was NSR Tuned. Okay, the thing with NSR Tuned, sarado sila ng January 15. Okay, that was, yeah, Saturday. So, again, because of the, you know, spike ng COVID cases, because of, again, the Omicron variant. So, I chatted with, okay, this is the shop, Moducare, and surprisingly, bukas sila, no? Bukas ang Moducare ng January 15, because Sabado lang ang oras ko talaga na, you know, para lumabas at maipakita or mailabas yung sasakyan for a checkup. So, I booked an appointment with them, and madaling araw ng Sabado, no, I left Baguio, and then I arrived there 7:30 in the morning. Kasi ang appointment is 8 o'clock in the morning. So, ako yung tao na, you know, always prompt. Hindi ako yung late. So, andun ako na 7:30. I'm 30 minutes, you know, early nang bukas nila ng alas 8. Okay? So, yun na nga. The car was, or the vehicle was checked by the mechanic that was, you know, that was assigned to my vehicle at the time last Saturday, and with one assistant. So confirmed ang leak ay mula sa power steering pump. Okay, so anong pinalitan, no? Ang pinalitan, hindi yung pump, hindi yung power steering pump, kundi yung mga O-rings lang, no? Yung, kung pag sinabing O-ring, yun yung mga, it's a rubber type. It, kaya O-ring, kasi nga, it's letter O and a ring made of rubber. So, yun yung pinalitan, no? Yun yung repair kit na tinatawag. Puro O-rings lang yung pinalitan. Siguro, masyado ng, hindi na makapit yung mga original O-rings. And that's why, there's a need to put a new O-rings dun sa steering pump, no? Power steering pump. And then, upon inspection, sabi ng mekaniko, sir, medyo you need to replace the bushings as well. So, pinakita na sa akin kung bakit papalitan na. Kasi dun sa bushing, may mga cracks na. Sabi ko, pag hindi ko pinalitan, tinanong ko, ano mangyari? Now, sabi ng mekaniko, it will lead to, you know, kalampag later on. So, I said, okay, andito na rin lang ako, might as well, you know, have it changed to replaced to a new bushing. So, yun yung ginawa, no, repair kit for the power steering pump. And then a new bushing for the big and small for the lower arm brace, no? Now, the whole repair lasted for uh, 10 hours. Bakit? Kasi dapat tapos na ako ng 5 o'clock, no? Naikabit na yung power steering pump. And then, ibibleed na lang dapat. So, nung 5 o'clock ng hapon, nung binibleed na, maingay ang steering. So, ang ginawa ng mechanic was to test drive the vehicle. Maingay pa din. And then, doon na nagkaroon ng issue, no? Akala nila, kung hindi power steering pump o-rings yung solusyon, then probably it might need a new power steering pump, in which at the time it was Saturday, siguro ang available lang would be a surplus power steering pump. So dumating ang 6 o'clock, no, may ginawa sila before going into the power steering pump replacement. They reflushed the power steering fluid ulit. And then what they do this time around was to actually fully bleed yung fluid. Pag sinabing bleeding, no, sa sasakyan, the process of bleeding is basically pag nag-flush ka kasi ng power steering fluid, may hangin na manggagaling dun sa power steering reservoir, dun sa yun yung parang container ng power steering fluid, and then may hangin na manggagaling dun sa pump pupunta ng rack and pinion, something like that, and that will cause for a full turn, left and right full turn, to squeak, may whining sound. Pag hindi na full bleed, pag ikot mo ng manibela mo, no, full turn, may sound, may whining sound na mangyayari. So, luckily, on the second time na na-reflushed yung power steering fluid, and then they did parang a full bleeding, nawala ang squeak, ang whining sound, and nag-test drive ang mechanic, and okay. So, saved me the trouble of replacing the power steering pump. And luckily, the repair kit did the magic, no? So, natapos ako ng 7 o'clock ng gabi. So, kulang-kulang na 12 hours for the whole process. Dapat tapos na ako ng 5 p.m. But the thing is, with the 5 p.m. mark, doon na sila nagkaroon ng parang issue. May sobrang ingay talaga ng power steering, or ng when you steer the vehicle, may ingay talaga. So, ang sinabi ko sa mekaniko, mas lalo pa atang lumala, no? Kasi nung dinala ko dito, from cold start, nawawala yung, after 5 minutes, nawawala na yung ingay when you steer the steering wheel. But this time around, no, thus the whining sound remains. So doon na sila somehow parang kinabahan. At ako, well, kinabahan din kasi yung tunog nga mas lumala, no? And luckily, no, the full bleeding worked. At right now, when I reach home ng Sabado ng gabi dito sa Baguio, it's a complete monitoring until now, no? I'm monitoring the power steering fluid kung may leak, but masasabi ko na ngayon walang leak, but I still have to have the vehicle, you know, travel far, kasi dito lang sa town pumupunta at hindi naman masyadong nilalabas sa sasakyan, so hindi ko talaga natetest fully. Okay, but the thing is, I am satisfied with the service that was done by Moducare. Okay, Moducare is the auto shop that I went my car to. At nakausap ko yung may-ari, which is Mr. Adrian Alba. Actually, I talked to Mr. Alba about the issue nung 5 o'clock pa lang. And that may kita mo naman yung sincerity nung may-ari kasi sabi niya, if we can extend a bit more, sir, no, we'll find a power steering pump for you. Or if not, kung wala, kung hindi talaga masusolusyonan, yun nga, gagawa sila lang parang. So sabi ko, sir, no problem. Mas gusto ko rin maayos yung sasakyan bago ko bumalik ng, you know, ng bahay ng Baguio. So, the owner, Mr. Alba himself, was monitoring my, you know, my going back home. Kasi every stop, I stop sa 2 gas stations, no? Just to check my fluid, power steering fluid, if there's a leak. So, he was monitoring me. Until pag-uwi ko sa bahay, I was actually chatting or sending him a text message about how is the fluid, how was the fluid, was there a leak, so and so forth. So, ganun. So, yun lang yun. If I were to rate the service ng Moducare, no, 10 being the highest and 1 being the lowest, basically, I'll be giving them 9, no? 9 out of 10. Yung 1 doon, dapat 10, no? Bakit hindi 10? Yung, kasi, dapat palang 5 o'clock na kuwi na ako eh. Dapat palang, hindi na nagkaroon ng reflashing, no? Dapat alam na nila yung gagawin, no? And that did not happen. So, kaya 9 lang. At 9 still a high, you know, rating for me. And again, sabi ko nga, I'm completely satisfied with the service that I got for my vehicle with Moducare. Bakit Moducare? Moducare, basically, nung nakuha ko yung Subaru Legacy, I joined, you know, the Legacy group sa Facebook. I also created my own group. No, and yan yung mga repair shops aside from Casa na lumabas, no. One of them was Moducare, and I already have inquired about the power steering way back in June pa of 2021. So ngayong buwan lang ako nagkaroon ng time na bisitahin ng Moducare at pakita yung pa-check yung sakyan, and hindi naman ako napaya. So yun. Actually, again, Moducare is my second option, as my first option was NSR Tune, but I'm happy that I landed with Moducare, no? So now I can say na for my next PMS, actually hindi na magkakasa, I'll be going with Moducare for the Subaru Legacy maintenance, no? Kasi motor image dito sa Pangasinan sumablay, hindi nila nakita yung leak. Dapat nakita nila yung leak eh. So, dun pa lang, yung kumpiyansa ko, nawala na. Diba? At the same time, qualified naman. Highly qualified ang mga mekaniko ng Moducare. So, saves me the trouble, saves me the trouble of, you know, spending lots of cash or money if I'll be going to the casa for a maintenance. So, with Moducare, at least they're using the same, you know, liquid or oils that Takasa uses, Motul, and that's it. Okay, so sa mga nagtatanong kung magkano inabot ng pagpapagawa ng power steering leak at yung mga bushing, I'll be reading you the, you know, the receipt, no? The steering pump repair kit costs 6,500 pesos. And for the installation and the dismantling ng power steering pump, it's 1,500 pesos. Okay, for the lower arm bushing, no, dalawang piraso yun, it's 2,000 for the big bushings. And then for the small bushings, that's 800. So that's 1,600. And for the pull down ng lowering arm, that's 1,400. And 4 pieces press out ng bushing, yun yung pagbabalik dun sa bushing, sa lower arm, that costs me once 1,600 pesos. So all in all, it's 15,150 pesos. Okay, 15,150 pesos ang inabot ko sa pagpapagawa ng power steering pump repair kit with the bushings ng lower arm, both, you know, left and right. And may 6 months warranty pag sa power steering pump. Okay, so now the 15,150 is discounted, no, hindi ng full price na binayaran ko. It was discounted less 500, so it landed me a cost of 14,650 pesos. All in all, I'm okay. I'm very happy kasi, as again, I'm checking the vehicle every now and then. The fluid level, the power steering fluid level is in its correct level when it's hot or when it's cold. Same time, dun sa sinabi ng mekaniko na dapat you watch out if there would be leaks dito sa mga part na to, wala. Okay, so I'm very satisfied sa ginawa ng Moducare. And maganda ang lokasyon ng Moducare kasi it's in Valenzuela, lalo na from the north, no. If you're coming from the north, lalabas ka lang ng Lingunan exit and tutumbukan mo lang 'yon. Yun na yung street nila, andun na. And pabalik, no, hindi na malayo sa NLEX, no. So, hindi ka na pupunta, papasok ng Metro Manila and hindi ka na makikipagsingitan sa traffic. No? Walang hassle na sa traffic. That's, again, another advantage. Location-wise, if you're coming from the north, no, maganda ang location ng Moducare. At the same time, highly qualified yung mga mechanics doon. And the owner himself, Mr. Adrian Alba, was so, you know, helpful. At, again, hindi na ako pinaya. Okay, so this ends the vlog episode of Marvin Says. Sa mga subscribers ko, maraming salamat. At kung may natutunan kayo, maraming salamat din. For this year, I will not encourage you to subscribe. Again, hindi ako nagko-content every week na. So, kung may oras lang. So, do not subscribe. Huwag na kayong mag-subscribe. Okay? Till next time, guys. Bye.